Good morning, good afternoon, good evening, wherever you might be, whatever you might be doing. We are going to start logs. Something you have not seen before. Okay, let's get into it. So it says here to graph y equals 2x. This is an exponential function. This we already know how to do. Let's graph that. You know that the y-intercept is 1. You know there is another point. If we make x be 1, y would be 2. Okay, and this will have a horizontal asymptote like this. And the graph would look something like that. This is y equals 2 to the x. And then it wants us to graph the inverse. Okay, this is going way back. What is an inverse? An inverse is where you switch x and y. So if we have an asymptote that is y equals 0 and we switch x and y, we're now going to have an asymptote that says x equals 0. Okay, this point that was 0, 1 will become 1, 0. This point that was 1, 2 will become 2, 1. Okay, and this graph looks something like that. Let's put that point on there. Okay, so this is the inverse of y equals 2x. This is actually the graph y equals log base 2 of x. So the log, the term logarithm, is used to describe the inverse of a power, of an exponential function. Okay, the inverse of 10 to the power x is log base 10 to the x. Okay, so that's kind of your introduction to logs. Logs are the inverses of exponential functions. Okay, the log of a number is an exponent. When I see this, log base b of c, it's the power to which b is raised to c. Now, I'm going to talk about that in a second. When I see this, all right, this is, I can think of that as an exponential. Okay, look back here. Here you have y equals 2 to the power x, and then you have log 2 to the power of x. Okay, so when I see log base b of c equals to a, this means the same thing as b to the power of a equals c. All right, so just to get that clear, when I see this right here, this means b to the power of a equals c. Okay, so when I see a log, when I see log, let me just erase some of this. When I see log b of c, this is saying b to what power? Okay, what power equals c? All right, so when I say that the log is an exponent, the exponent is what power of b equals c? All right, couple of conditions about that. B has to be greater than 0, b cannot be 1, c has to be greater than 0. All right, if you think about that, if you have an exponent with a base of b, no matter what you put here, it's always 1. So you can't have a base that is 1. Okay, it also can't be 0, or it has to be bigger than 0, it has to be a positive number, in other words. Okay, so we'll keep that in mind. Those are some restrictions on the log. Just like with the exponential function, the base had to be positive. Same with the log. Okay, so let's get used to using the logs here. These are exponential expressions. Can we change them into log expressions? So this says 3 to the power 3 is 27. If I want to change that to a log, the base is 3, and the answer is 27. So this is saying 3 to what power is 27? It's 3. Okay, let's try another one. So log, what's the base here? The base is 5. Okay, so 5 to what power is 1 over 25? It's negative 2. Here, the base is 4. The answer is 1. So 4 to what power is 1? It's 0. Okay. Vice versa, let's change this to an exponential equation. So 7 is the base to what power equals 49? Okay, 4 to what power is 1 over 64? 10 to what power is 1 over 10,000? All right, so that's kind of what a log is. All right, we're going to get used to using these a lot. There's a couple other things that we should know. The first is what we call the common log. All right, the common log is a base 10. Now, just like when we have the square root, we don't write the 2 in there. If we have a base 10 for a log, you often don't write the base 10. So you could see this as just log 5. All right? And base 10 is something that's on your calculator. So I want you to grab your calculator right now and just type that in. We just want log 5. Okay? So this is, and how many decimals should we write this to? Usually we go to 3 decimals, so that's right here, so this would round that off, so 0.699. If you're not sure, just write out as many decimals as you see, that'll never be wrong. Okay, log of 24, this is 1.380. Okay, and 46, this is 1.663. Okay, now sometimes they're not going to be base 10. That means you're not going to use a calculator. Now, I know some of you guys actually have calculators that have different bases. You can do that. But typically, questions that have different bases, like this one, this is telling you that we're not supposed to use a calculator. This will be on the non-calculator part of a test. Okay? So to do this question, what I'm going to do is I'm going to put a little, let x equal the answer. So this answer we're going to find, I'm going to call it x. See, what I just did here is I changed an expression into an equation, so that's why I'm saying what the x is. So when I see this, I can now change this to an exponential equation. 5 to the power of x equals 3,125. And this should look familiar because these can be written as the same base. So 5 is what power? Sorry, 3,125 is 5 to what power? Well, 5 squared is 25, 5 cubed is 625, 5 to the power 4 is 3,025. So this means x is 4. Okay, so you could go back here and you could say, well, now I know this equals 4. Okay, let's try this one again. I'm going to say let x be the answer. So I'm going to have 6 to the power of x is 1 over 216. So can I write 216 as a power of 6? Yes, it is to the power 3. But since it's in the denominator, it's 6 to the negative 3. And so x is negative 3. Okay, this one's a little bit trickier. But again, we'll change an exponential equation. 8 to the power of x is 2 cube root of 2. Now I need these all to be powers of 2, so I have 2 cubed to the power x equals 2 to the power 1 times 2 to the power 1/3. So 2 to the 3x equals 2 to the 4/3. Remember, you add the exponents there. So 3x is 4/3, x is 4/9. Okay, if you're not sure how to get that, this is 4/3 divided by 3, which is the same thing as 4/3 times 1/3. Okay, So that's a bit of a review actually in there. Let's do a couple more questions to the nearest tenth estimate. Okay, estimate is not typically a test question because it's hard to mark that, because what is when is an estimate right and when is it wrong? If you're estimating, that means it's not the exact value, it just means it's approximately. So when I see this and I want to estimate, let's take a look at some that I would know for sure. I know exactly what this equals, because 5 to what power is 25? I know that's 2. Okay? I also know that log base 5 to 125 is 3. This is right in the middle of that. So I know that this is somewhere between 2 and 3. Now, you'll find that it's not really right in the middle, but an estimate is okay to say it's somewhere in the middle. You could maybe argue that it's closer to 125, so maybe you want to say 2.6. That's not really important. The idea is that you can estimate approximately what the value is, that you understand that it's somewhere between 2 and 3. Okay? I won't ask you that on the test. I have seen that on an exam. Just a one-mark question, and the key there is it won't care about this answer. It'll care about the idea that you have to justify. What does justify mean? Justify means you have to show that that's a reasonable answer. And so what I just did here would be the way to justify it. You know that it's between 2 and 3. Okay. Back to graphing. When I see this, quickly in my head, I'm thinking, well, I know what y equals 4 to the x looks like. It looks like this. So what's the log look like? Well, the log is going to be something like this. I know it's going to have an asymptote here, x equals 0. I know it's going to cross at 1, just like the exponential graph always crossed at y as 1. And then I need another point. Okay, so what is going to be my other point? Well, when we had the exponential, we said, well, let's let the other value be 0. Okay, so right here what we did is we said, look, if we make y be 0, I know that x is 1. So now let's pick another value for y. Let's pick y is 1. Then what is x? Well, 4 to what power is x? Well, if y is 1, it's 4 to the power of 1. So you get 4. So what is this point? X is 4, y is 1. Okay? So if you're not sure how to do this, when you do the graph, since it's the inverse of an exponential function, pick y values to find x values. And typically, you're going to pick y is 0 and 1. Okay? Intercepts, x-intercept is 1, y-intercept, there are none. There is an equation of an asymptote of x equals 0. And you'll see the domain is exactly what the range was in an exponential function, and the range is exactly what the domain was in an exponential function. Okay, so let's graph a few more of these. I want you to get good at these. I don't really think you need a table of values. Okay, if you think about, you know, let's quickly do a thought here. What was the exponential function? What did that look like? It looked like instead of going up like this, it was down. So if we're going to do the inverse of that, okay, let's think about a normal log function goes like this. So what's the inverse of that? It's going to go like this. Okay, I know this is going to be 1, and then I'm going to pick another value. If I pick y is 1, what is x? If y is 1, I get 1 quarter to the power of x. Okay, so let's just quickly do that here. If I get y is 1, this is 1 quarter to the power of 1, which is 1 quarter. So right about here, I have this point 1 quarter, 1. Okay? All right. Identify the intercepts. X-intercept is 1. Y-intercept is none. Asymptote is x is 0. The domain is 0 to infinity. The range is negative infinity to infinity. Okay, so concluding statement, the log function is the inverse of the exponential function. I think that is the end for today. Okay, a little bit of an easy day today. There will be quite a bit of log homework coming up in the next few lessons.